Hi, my name is Katie Taylor, and I'm a specialist with the PATINS Project, and I'm here with Shireen Hafeez, the founder of Deaf Kids Code. Thanks for being here with us today.
Thank you for having me.
Did you know that our students who are deaf or hard of hearing are at 70% risk for underemployment when they graduate high school?
Yes, not just underemployment, but unemployment. Over 70% of all new jobs are in the field of technology and computing, which bypasses the barriers that normally have existed in the past, where communication would be the primary challenge. So, on the premise of that the digital age is the great equalizer, I started the organization Deaf Kids Code. Deaf Kids Code actually challenges the status quo. It is disruptive. So what we do is we go into schools and work with institutions, and we provide hands-on, interactive, engaging, project-based learning. So we don't get necessarily into vocabulary where what is an algorithm. It doesn't matter. What matters more is that our kids can create an algorithm rather than understanding the word. And we have had incredible results. I established this organization with the idea that it would be a local grassroots organization. But through word of mouth, the demand nationally, the demand to scale, has just blown up. And so now we are a national outreach organization.
With programming like this, we could help bridge the economic and social gaps that exist among the students who are deaf and hard of hearing through developing computing and technology skills.
Yeah, correct. I mean, actually, one of the biggest dilemmas that when you hear folks from Apple and Google and Microsoft, what they say is that the largest gap of skills that they're looking for are creative thinkers. Who is going to be the better problem solver and innovator than an individual who is born with a disability, living and cultivating their life in a world that does not bend towards accessibility? Who is going to be the natural problem solver? It's going to be our kids. Because it's not just about a return of investment for companies, but it's a return of society for all of us.
How can we do our part in Indiana to make sure that our students who are deaf or hard of hearing are introduced to these skills in this high demand field?
Well, there are two things. The first thing I'm thinking about is that Indiana, you know, just like all over the country, has a skill gap. So one of the biggest topics going on in our state are that you have all these job openings where they cannot find enough people with the skill set to fill those positions. The good news is that computer science is now being integrated into curriculum within our education system. And the other, you know, thing to consider is computer science is actually the new literacy. It's going to matter more that our children have those skills than to know how to write cursive. If you are really paying attention to where we are, even in today's world, you'll understand that not just in today's world, but in what's going to happen in 5 or 10 years from now, what is going to be the demand if the demand is so exponential now? And they project that by the year 2020, there's going to be over 1 million openings, and we might actually already be there.
So Shireen, can you tell us how our teachers and our school programs, if they're interested in implementing some of these ideas into their schools, how can they help?
So Deaf Kids Code, it's important to mention, is a nonprofit organization, and we are a zero barrier to access organization, which means that we do not charge schools, institutions, educators, students, or parents to bring programming to our children. They can go to our website, which is deafkidscode.org, and it's really that simple.
That's great.
Yeah.
So please don't hesitate to reach out to Shireen at deafkidscode.org and us at PATINS Project via Facebook, Twitter, or our website, patinsproject.org.